Why I hate the change type step in Power BI. The one that's always added automatically. I delete it every single time, and maybe you should too. If you've ever had a refresh fail out of nowhere or watched a perfectly good query break after a tiny change in the source, chances are this step had something to do with it. And if it hasn't happened yet, it's just a matter of time. But I'll show you the smart way to deal with it. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online program on learnpowerbi.com, I've helped thousands of business users master Power BI and build beautiful reports. So let me show you one of the client files I work with. Look at this, lots of columns, and that's totally fine. You don't always have control over what the source data looks like. And I really don't care, because I have Power Query, the kitchen of Power BI. Now in this case, I'm just extracting a few of these columns, but watch what happens when I bring it into Power BI. So I connect to this file and Power BI does its thing. And what do I see? It adds these automatic steps, including our lovely friend, the change type step. And I'm like, okay, fine, whatever. Now I'll only keep the columns I need. I hit close and apply and everything works. So you might be thinking, Avi, what were you so upset about? Here's the big deal. The change type step, it creates a hard-coded dependency on every single one of those column names. If you look at that step, it lists out all of them, even the ones I don't care about. Now imagine something changes on the client side, and trust me, it does. Stuff always changes, and I'm okay with that. If it impacted the columns that I care about, I'll fix it. But if it's one of the other 150 other columns, I don't care about. Well, I don't want it to break my refresh, but that's exactly what is going to happen. So what do you do? Simple. Always, always delete that automatic change type step and only add back the change type for number one, the columns you care about, and then number two, filter those to only the ones that are not text. That is typically date or some kind of a number. It keeps the hard coding of the column name to a minimum. Now you might think that this is something small, trivial, but it's exactly these kinds of details, this level of care that separates a Power BI Pro from the rest. It's about making the right choices, building good habits, and following best practices project after project. If you want to learn more about the core concepts and best practices in Power BI, check out my training program at learnpowerbi.com. I'll see you in the next one. Take care and power on.